Hi folks, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande. Welcome to the second video of Dependency Injection. In this video, we will actually get started with discussion of different types of dependency injections that are out there. To get started, the very common dependency injection is constructor dependency injection or simply constructor injection. And then you have setter injection, interface injection, method injection, ambient injection, static injection, and last but not the least, field injection. Of course, this is not very complete exhaustive list of all the types of dependency injection, but these are the most commonly used dependency injection types. If you are familiar with this, you are more or less almost well covered. Let's get started with the first one, which is constructor injection. Let's have a look at this particular code. It's a class called country repository and it takes three parameters, and all these are constructor parameters: the country list service provider, country DAO, dispatcher. You need not worry what these actually are, just understand semantic and syntax of how this looks like. So what's the pattern here? Dependencies are being passed through constructor. Country repository is the client class, and country list service provider, country DAO, and dispatcher, these are all the dependencies that it needs. And we are passing these dependencies as constructor parameter. So the class needs dependencies to function since very its instantiation. It is good idea to inject these at the time of instantiation when the constructor is getting invoked. What are the advantages of this kind of dependency injection? Well, it guarantees a valid object state by enforcing dependency injection at the creation time itself. You don't have to worry about a situation where the object is already there, but the dependencies are not created inside the object, and because of that, something might go wrong. That situation is completely ruled out. All the dependencies are passed at the time of constructor invocation itself. That's one advantage. Another one is dependencies are immutable, set once via constructor. So if you want to ensure that these dependencies are not fiddled with later, then the good idea is to make them as constructor injection. And then it basically enforces the dependency inversion by making dependencies explicit. Anybody who looks at the constructor, that person will immediately understand what are the dependencies of that particular class. So it is very easy on eyes when someone is trying to understand the code. That's the advantage of constructor injection. But however, there are certain disadvantages as well with this kind of constructor injection. The first one is it may lead to cumbersome, lengthy constructors with many dependencies. In this case, I have only three dependencies to pass, but let's assume that this class needs even 5 or 6 dependencies. Suddenly passing it through a constructor, the constructor parameter list looks very huge. And passing all those things at the time of object instantiation itself might not be even necessary. And then dependencies are fixed post-creation. That is, once the dependencies are passed at the time of object creation, you can't change them unless you have some kind of other mechanism to change it. But usually the assumption is once the dependencies are passed through the constructor, you are left with that to be used throughout the lifecycle of that object. And this problem is what the setter injection tries to solve. Take for example this code. Here the country repository has various parameters, constructor injections that are being passed. And what is the first one? That is service provider. And that is country list service provider. So right now, the service provider is getting initialized with country list provider via network. Maybe it is a type of country list service provider. Now, assume that this object instantiation is very resource intensive. You probably don't want to create it at the time of instantiating the country repository. Maybe you want to probably create the country repository without service provider initially, but then you want to set this service provider much later. Well, what you can do is you can have a setter method, that is a set country list service provider inside the country repository. What this allows you to do is pass the dependency after the country repository object has been created. So this mechanism, which is basically using a setter method to provide the dependency after the object has been created, offers more flexibility to change the dependency post object creation. That is the advantage of this mechanism. And especially in cases where lifecycle based dependencies need to be managed, this becomes very handy to use. But then there are also disadvantages. Dependency at object creation isn't guaranteed, risking an invalid or incomplete state. If by chance someone who doesn't know how to use country repository forgets to pass this dependency before using any of the methods from the country repository, then things might go wrong. So it offers the flexibility, but then there is always a risk involved wherein the object is created without the dependency it needs to function properly. And the second part is it makes the object mutable, because you can call setter methods any point in time later, and that is risking issues if dependencies change unexpectedly. Then comes the interface injection. This we shall see in the next video, because this would require some serious time. That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.